Now let's discuss the differences between cell membrane and cell wall. As explained to you earlier, a cell wall can be seen only in a plant cell, whereas cell membrane is found both in plant and in animal cells. Like this is an animal cell, it is surrounded by a cell membrane, but here you will find that outside this cell membrane there is a cell wall. So first difference is cell wall is present only in a plant cell, but cell membrane is present both in animal as well as in a plant cell. Secondly, cell wall is a non-living layer and it is made up of a non-living substance which is called cellulose. You will find cellulose in your book underlined, a non-living substance. Whereas cell membrane is made up of lipoproteins. So this is the second difference. Composition of cell membrane is composed of lipoproteins and cell wall is made up of a non-living substance called cellulose. Another difference is cell membrane is living in nature, whereas cell wall, as explained to you, is non-living in nature. This is the third difference. Along with this, their permeability varies. Cell membrane is selectively permeable or semi-permeable in nature, which means it allows only certain substances to pass through while it prevents others. Whereas a cell wall is freely permeable, which means it allows all substances to enter and leave the cell without any obstruction or without any hindrance. So I hope you've understood the four points of difference between cell wall and cell membrane. Cotton, jute, coconut fibers are the cell walls of their dead cells. So we derive these fibers basically from the cellulosic cell walls. Moving on to the cytoplasm. Cytoplasm is a jelly-like substance which fills this space, that is the space between the nuclear membrane and between the outer cell membrane. This space is filled with a jelly-like liquid which is called the cytoplasm. Inside this cytoplasm, all the tiny living parts are present which are called the cell organelles. These organelles perform different functions. So whatever functions these organelles perform basically come under the function of cytoplasm. So it is a semi-liquid substance filling the space between the nuclear and the cell membrane. It is the site where all chemical reactions take place. You can take the functions. Many chemical reactions take place in the cytoplasm, and this cytoplasm is always in a state of movement. It contains various organelles which perform different functions. So function can be, it is the site of all chemical reactions, and it has various organelles in it which perform specific functions of the cell. This organelle, what you can see here it is in rough in nature, here it is smooth, is endoplasmic reticulum. So we'll do the first organelle, that is endoplasmic reticulum. Three things have to be prepared for every organelle: S, L and F. S is the structure, L is the location and F is the function. You can write the full forms here. So what is the structure of endoplasmic reticulum? It is an irregular network of double membranes. It is an irregular network of double membranes. This is its structure, which may be rough or which may be smooth. This is also the structure. Rough, when it has ribosomes on it here, and that is a beaded appearance, and smooth when it is without the ribosomes. So we have rough ER, RER, and we